Welcome to Ranchi Cook, the kitchen friends. Hope you all are safe at home and very healthy. You must be trying a number of recipes at home. Do try this recipe. It is called Shaguti. This is a traditional recipe of Goa and you'll find it in every home. But the style of preparing it is different. Now, the process of making the shaguti is a very long process. So what I have done is I have divided it into 4 steps. Okay, and also roasting and all, it takes a lot of time and energy. So what I have done is I have roasted all the spices, the whole spices, and I have made a powder. We call it samar. This samar, I have prepared it and kept it beforehand. The recipe for samar, I'll be putting it in the description box, and I think you'll find it in the same samar I'm using for tornaks. I'm using it for chanyacho roast, the same samar. This is the same samar, but for shaguti, I'll put it in the description box. When you prepare shaguti, please keep a portion of shaguti aside, because I'll be showing you one more recipe related to this, that is called rose omelette. Rose omelette is a traditional street food in Goa, and I think every corner of Goa, every lane, you will find one dhaba. They are making this rose omelette, but now it is not safe to eat outside. So try this recipe, prepare it at home, and very easy. For the vegetarians, I understand ki they cannot eat, they are not eating eggs, or they are not eating chicken or mutton. So for them, I'll give you one more variation. What they can do is, instead of omelette, they can prepare tomato omelette, or they can prepare besan omelette also. The recipes I will make it, and I'll put it some other time. But if you all are preparing these omelettes at home, so use it for roast omelette. Now for the roast or the gravy portion, what you can do is you can use chanyacho roast, or you can use the akurache tona if you find akur, or you can use mushroom masala. The recipes I have already uploaded, but I'll give them in the links I will put in the description box for you. So try these recipes and let me know how you all liked it. Stay at home and be safe. Step 1, marinating the chicken. I've taken 3/4 kg of chicken. For that, I'll be taking 200 grams of curd, a little coriander, then 4 to 5 green chilies, again depending on how spicy the chilies are, one full onion of garlic, one full garlic, and 1 inch ginger, little salt. Grind all the ingredients to a fine paste and marinate the chicken in this this mixture. See here, I've made a very fine paste. Now I'll be marinating this chicken. Please wash and clean the chicken thoroughly before marinating it. Now it is better to marinate for 24 hours, like the previous day you marinated and the next day you make the shaguti. Now let us do the second step, that is making the masala or vatan. Now, as I've already told you, I have made samar, or the whole spices I've already made a powder and kept it aside. So we won't be adding any whole spices in this. I have sliced onions, around 3 to 4 onions, and then take little oil, that is 3 to 4 teaspoons of oil in a kadai, and fry it till it becomes golden brown. This is the color that we need. Then add 1 cup of fresh grated coconut. you will need to fry that also till it is golden brown. We are not adding any spices except for khaskhas. These are poppy seeds. Just 1 teaspoon is enough. So now see here, I'm roasting it on a very slow flame. You need to roast it, otherwise the onion and the fresh coconut will get burnt. So fry it on a very slow flame. Now let us grind it with little tamarind. I have soaked tamarind, add little water and grind it to a very fine paste. Yeah, this is the tamarind that I have soaked. We won't need the entire lot, just a little bit is enough for this. Now here, see, I have made a very smooth paste. Keep it aside. Let us move on to the step 3, that is cooking the chicken. See, I have already removed and kept it aside, kept it out of the deep freeze in the morning, and I'm doing it in the afternoon. So the chicken is nicely marinated. Now I'm using a cooker to make it. Add 1 or 2 tablespoons of oil in a pan or a cooker and add finely chopped onion to it. Fry it till light brown color. Now add the marinated chicken. When see, you can see it has become light brown. Now don't add the entire lot. We need to fry the chicken pieces. So I'm squeezing the chicken pieces and I'm adding. See this, the gravy portion I'm keeping it aside. We will add it later on. Yeah, just roast it and for a few minutes you need to saute it. This is the easiest recipe. I have simplified it for you people. So I think you will get the same taste that you get which we make traditionally. Here I have added a little bit of red chili powder and haldi. Fry it for a few minutes. Now add the gravy. That is the marinated gravy that you need, and little whole 1 onion I have chopped it finely and I have added. Now the step 4, I'm doing it side by side, that is extracting the coconut milk. This gives a very good flavor to the chicken. Now what I have done is 1 cup of fresh coconut I have taken, added little water and grind it to a fine paste. Now squeeze the milk. See here, you got coconut milk. Keep it aside. This should be around half cup or half a cup is enough. Now here we have cooked the chicken. As I told you, we have already cooked the chicken. Now this is the sambar. This is the sambar. Okay, I have already told you before that I have made the sambar and kept aside. This is the sambar. Now you can use 1 or 2 teaspoons according to your taste. Just mix well. And again cook it. Cook for a few minutes. We don't want that, we want the fresh smell of sambar and we want it cooked also. So just a few minutes are enough. Already the whole spices are roasted, so there is no problem. See here. Now you can see that the chicken has started to boil. The gravy is boiling. When the gravy starts to boil, add the ground paste of onion and the coconut that we have already made a paste with tamarind. Now see here, I'm adding the ground masala. Wash the jar with little water because I find that the chicken is quite dry, so we don't want a dry version. If you want, you add according to your the consistency that you want, you can add the quantity of water. But we prefer it a bit thick. See here, you can see it started boiling. When it starts to boil and when the masala is cooked, add the coconut milk. Cook for a few minutes. See here, just 4 or 5 minutes are more than enough. Just give it a boil and then you can off the gas. See here, just a boil and you can off the gas. Now add coriander seeds, now add, garnish it with coriander leaves. Your shagruti is ready. You can have it with pav or you can have it with chapati, rice, as you wish. Enjoy it.